Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today I'm going to show you a couple of tricks to memorize Persian words. Okay, let's get started with the picture on the right. Noon. So remember in Farsi, we always write from right to left. Noon. Okay. Let's see, how can we memorize this word? Noon. Obviously, it means bread, but how can we actually memorize it? Now, I know that in the U.S., people who are interested in international cuisine, anytime they go to Indian restaurant, they will ask for naan bread, right? That's one way of remembering noon, because in fact, these two words are the same. Also, Spanish speakers will refer to noon as pan. So, if you speak Spanish, you will notice that there is the N element there in both of these words. Pan, noon. Now, this one was easy. Most people won't have any problem remembering this word. But let's go to the other one, the picture on the left. Okay, again, we are going to write it in Persian script. Right to left, panir, panir, panir. Again, if you speak Hindi or, you know, other Middle Eastern languages, you may be able to find some links between this word and the equivalent for this word in your language. However, many people who do not speak those languages, they cannot remember this word. Cheese in English and queso in Espanol, they don't have anything in common with the word panir. So, how do we learn this? Okay. First, let's focus on those who know Spanish or speak Spanish. We're going to start with focusing on this phrase, nuno panir. Bread and cheese. Nuno panir. It's a phrase that's commonly used in Iran. It's a quick form of snack, very popular. So, pan y queso. Now, let's have a closer look. Look, the word pan in Espanol and pan in panir, they're kind of connected, right? They're the same thing. So, maybe, just maybe, if you're familiar with Spanish, you can kind of form an association between this word, pan, y, the first syllable of panir. Therefore, your brain can remember the word panir much more easily because it would associate it with the word pan, which is bread and cheese go together, right? So you see how it works. We are using a word that you already know and combining it with something you don't know. Pan y panir. So this was a quick trick for people who know Spanish. But what if you don't speak Spanish and your only reference is English? How would you remember the word panir for cheese? Let's have a look. In English, we have the word pan. So, put the cheese in the pan. That's the trick. So you want to form a mental image of you putting some cheese into the pan. And here the word pan and panier will automatically get associated in your brain with the word cheese. Put the cheese in the pan. That's the trick. Okay, now let's review. This thing here was noon, and this thing here was panir. I hope you will remember these words now. Ta bad.